order.
Darn those bears. They're everywhere. I can never seem to outrun them. Oh, it's good to be home. Who's calling me? Yeah?
Vic, you sound tired. Wake up! Now tell me, are those two bears still running around over there?
Oh, yeah. They're around, all right. For the life of me, I can't get rid of those two.
That's great! I want you to give me a bear paw!
That's pretty cruel, dude. I mean, what's it gonna do for you? Make you feel like a big man or something?
I am a big man, you lumberjack! I meant a paw print! For my son! He's collecting them!
That's a relief, I tell you. I thought you'd gone off your rocker.
Do this and you'll get a full paid vacation!
Really?
Of course! Oh. Provided that you give me a perfectly flawless bear paw print! What if you don't? You can get that vacation goodbye, Victor!
You got it. Whatever it takes. I want a bear paw. He's so selfish. He only thinks about himself. But still, I could sure use it. Just think about it. No more trees, no more bears or bees. Just me on the beach without a care in the world. Relaxation, here I come. I can do this. I'll get that print and be on the beach in no time. Yeah!
Right, to the left. Left. A little higher, bro.
Ramble, you really need to lose some weight.
Almost got it. We did it! So worth it.
I just need to trick him into making a paw print. Should be easy as pie.
Oh no! The bees are back!
They're careful not get stung. Your feet will swell and the print won't be perfect. Come on! Follow me!
Uncle Vic!
We did it! Take that, you lousy stingers!
Uncle Vic, you rescued us! Here, take this honey as a reward.
Don't mention it. Go ahead and keep it, Bramble. Did the bees hurt your paws? Let me have a look.
Nope, all good.
Phew, that's really good. I'm thankful.
Why is Logger Vic acting so weird? Well, Logger Vic, thanks a million, but we gotta go now.
No, wait, please don't go yet. I've got some fruitcake at my cabin. It's way better than honey, am I right?
A cake? Hey, bro, that cake sounds really good.
Let's go then. Right this way.
What could Logger Vic be up to?
Fruitcake, 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 fruitcake.
Hooah! All right, who wants some?
Fruitcake!
Just a sec.
Yeah.
Logger Vic, you better not be planning anything.
No plans, just cake. All righty.
Hey, Briar, why are you such a worrywart? It fixed up to no good. Why did he save us?
Here you go, Bramble. Have at it. And now that he's been blinded by cake, I can ask him for anything I want. Phone's ringing. Make yourself at home.
What's going on here? Time to find out.
Yes, boss. I am so close to getting that bear paw you wanted. Too good. Don't forget my vacation.
Logger Vic wants to take our paws from us. How could he be so cruel? That's it. We're leaving. Bramble, we're going home.
What about my after-cake nap?
You'll take it later.
Hey, fellas. What are you in such a hurry for? I thought we could share some fruit before you go.
Fruit?
We have this other thing that we have to do today.
What? We don't have fruit.
Thanks for everything. Bye.
What happened? I forgot to ask him about their paw prints.
No way! What would Vic want with our paws?
I just don't know, but we have to stop him somehow.
That's no good! I like my paws, my soft little paws. Briar, what do we do? What's that? Longer Vic? He must have followed us home. What are we gonna do, bro?
Vic wants a paw without defect, right? Huh? I have a plan.
Briar doesn't want to talk to me today. I better ask Bramble first.
Bramble? Aren't you supposed to be picking weeds now?
I sure wish I was taking a nap. These weeds are so prickly. It hurts so bad. If I keep going, I'll ruin my perfect little paws. But I have to.
And that'll ruin my vacation. Shoot. Don't move!
Huh? Longer Vic? Could you give me a hand?
Of course. You go ahead and rest, and I'll take care of all the yard work.
Oh, but there are so many weeds.
It's a cake. Just sit here. Okay. I'll take care of it.
Come on, let me help you.
I got it. Yeah? Sit down.
Bramble? You're done yet? Bramble?
Not my honey! Hey, Briar, look it!
My hands are killing me. But perfect paws are the result.
Oh, yeah. We're all out of fruit. Go to the trees and pick some apples.
But I'm bad at climbing. Every time I pick fruit, I fall and hurt my poor little paws. Oh, man.
Bramble, no complaining. You have to finish your chores. Get to it.
Huh? Now I have to climb trees, too. Briar's such a taskmaster. Just think of the vacation. It should all work out in the end.
Oh, man, the tree's bark is so rough. My paws are throbbing with pain.
I can't let him hurt his paws. Hey, Bramble, let me climb it for you. I'm a pro.
Really? Thanks, Vic. Just pick these here. I'll be here if you need me.
So tall. I can do this. This is tougher than I thought. Oh, yeah. I almost forgot my scissors.
What? Who carries around garden shears? Where was he even keeping those things?
Hey, check out these clippers. What's the matter?
Put those things away! Why do you even have them?
It makes getting the apples easy. What are you so scared for?
Briar, help me! Longer Vic is trying to take my paws!
You're weirding me out, man.
Longer Vic, what are you doing to Bramble?
It's not what you're thinking. Just let me explain. I don't want to take your paws.
That's enough out of you. I've already heard your whole plan.
Heard what exactly?
We heard your telephone conversation with your boss.
Well, you heard wrong.
Let's go.
Let me explain. Why can't you just hear me out? You two never want to listen to anything I have to say, do you?
We would listen to you if you would stop lying.
I can't take it anymore! Get back here! I'm gonna get you!
Bramble, stay close!
Wait for me!
Hurry up!
Stop there!
Huh?
What?
Look what I found. Bramble, jump on!
Wait for me! I'm gonna get you! Rotten bear! Stop! There's a good reason for all of this!
Okay!
You just want a paw print? We're so sorry, Vic. We should have listened instead of jumping to conclusions.
It's fine. I don't have any hard feelings.
Lugger Vic, you're the best.
Yeah, you can have all the paw prints you want.
Really? I win!
Sky Lanterns, up, up, and away!
It sure has been nice spending the Mid-Autumn Festival with you.
Huh?
This last mooncake is mine!
Let go!
It's mine!
It's mine!
I called it!
Give it! I've got an idea.
What idea?
Let's have a competition. Just a little one, though, okay?
A competition?
Whoever flies their lantern the highest gets to eat the mooncake.
Sounds fun! What do you say?
Let's do it. Should be easy peasy if we work together.
Lugger Vic, don't eat it while we're away.
What are you insinuating?
I'm just making sure. I got my eye on you.
That cake will be mine soon anyway.
Hey. Huh? That didn't work.
It's almost done.
Bramble, can that thing fly?
I don't really know. I'm all out of ideas! Maybe we should ask Lugger Vic.
Ask Lugger Vic? Hey, I got it!
With this book here, I'll make the best sky lantern of all. Oh, boy. You're not supposed to be here. Get away. This is called cheating, you know. This is just unforgivable. I'll make it in the forest.
What are we gonna do now?
Don't worry about it. I've memorized the whole process.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Great!
Shh, keep it down. Let's get out of here. All done. Huh?
Ta-da!
We'll need to catch some fireflies from the well. Let it begin.
Come here. Wow, it's beautiful.
We are gonna win this game.
Lugger Vic! Huh? Lugger Vic! Don't tell me you're scared of our gorgeous sky lantern. Hey, Briar, he's not in there.
Huh? Then we'll just have to wait for him.
La 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 la. I am so good at making lanterns. This one's even better looking than the one in the book. It's late. I'll take the shortcut home. It'll be quicker. Hi, boy. I've been here before. This way'll do. What's happened to me? Have I lost? Don't give up. Never give up, never surrender. I'll go this way. I'm going in circles. What am I gonna do now? I can't believe it.
Ah!
Well, this is bad. Somebody, help! Help!
Bro, look! Wow! It's beautiful! So that's what a Sky Lantern looks like when it's flying. I like it.
Well, that's strange. He let it go early.
What's wrong?
It's a competition. We were supposed to do it together. He broke the rules. Let's find out why.
Wait for me!
Now, where did that guy go?
You smell that? Isn't that one of Logger Vic's shoes?
Yeah!
Oh, gross!
Maybe he's in danger. Maybe he sent that Sky Lantern as a distress signal. It's coming from that way. Let's go check it out.
Oh, brave bears. I hope you see my lantern and come for me.
Logger Vic!
I'm over Vic. Here! Down
Logger
here!
Hey, I hear him over there!
Here.
Logger Vic, is that you?
Of course it's me! I'm over here! Follow my voice!
Vic, we're coming!
Hold on!
He's here!
Bramble!
Briar!
Huh? Come on!
Just stay still, Briar, or you'll sink deeper! It's quicksand, you can't struggle!
Bramble, pull us out of this stuff!
Okay, grab my hand! Grab hold!
It's no use, I can't reach you.
Hey, Bramble, find something that you can pull us out with, okay?
Okay, wait for me, I'll look! Let's see, aha!
I tried to warn you guys, but you just had to fall in, didn't you?
You think I want to be in here?
Hold on to this! I'll pry you up!
Bramble, try and find a bigger one!
A bigger one? This trunk will do! It's ready, Briar!
I'll climb up first, then I'll pull you up. Almost there! Bramble, maybe you should find some rope.
Where am I gonna find rope in the forest? Hey, maybe this vine will do.
All right, Vic, you're up. Bramble, pull now!
I need some help.
Ready?
Ready! What can I do? It's just not enough. Wait, Briar, I have a plan.
What plan?
We can use the Sky Lantern. I'll make a super big one and then pull you two up.
Yeah, good idea, bro. Go, go. Remember the fireflies.
Pardon me, Briar. What are those for?
Because they'll take the lantern up into the sky and you'll be pulled up.
The lanterns don't need fireflies to go up into the sky.
Okay.
Go get the supplies from my house and I'll tell you how it works. Yeah! Finally free!
Briar!
Thanks, for saving me. I appreciate it.
Oh, Vic, how come I didn't need to catch any fireflies?
Oh, that's right. You want to know how a Sky Lantern works.
Tell me.
When you light the lantern, the air inside heats up. And hot air is lighter than cold air, so it rises into the sky. Pretty cool, huh?
I didn't understand a single word of that.
Well, Vic, looks like me and Bramble won the competition.
Yeah, I agree. I made a giant Sky Lantern to save you guys out of that swamp, so I guess you'll give the mooncake to us, right?
You're right.
Oh, boy.
What the?
What happened?
Somebody's been eating it.
Logger Vic?
Well, it wasn't me, I swear it. Oh, but I have no idea.
Go home. You're responsible. I demand an explanation. Stop!
Bananas are much better.
Quilt City.
Huh? I finally found it! I'm okay. Huh? Look at all this cotton! I better hurry and tell the bears the good news!
Oh boy, I just need one more big tree or I'll never meet Boss Lee's quota. Cool, it's perfect. Yay! No bears anywhere. Not again! Darn it! Worthless piece of junk! That was quick. So cold. So fast, too. Go on, go away! You asked for it! You get out of here! Hey-o! I'm having a bad time! Oh, my beautiful. Just dreamy. All this cotton will make a fine quilt for me this winter. And it'll give me something to do in my spare time. Ooh la la. Oh, yeah. I'll make one for my mama as well. Come to me. Wee. I thought it'd be softer than that.
Bramble, Hoo-Hoo, our cotton plants are ready!
Mm-hmm. There was so much cotton, so fluffy and white, so beautiful!
Oh, yeah! It's wonderful!
Huh? Briar! Hey, Bramble! What are you two doing over there?
Oh, we're planting cotton. When the autumn comes, we'll harvest it to make our house nice and soft and toasty, too.
We had to travel a long way to get these seeds.
Look, bro.
Our blooming cotton field.
Huh? That's so cool! Can I help you guys? Huh?
I caught all these worms for you. Look.
Wow! Thank you, Bramble.
Hoo-Hoo, do you think you could watch our cotton plants for us?
You're gonna have to check them every day.
Of course. I promise.
Hoo-Hoo, I can't wait anymore. Let's go have a look.
Yeah, let's go.
Come on, everybody.
Huh?
I can't believe it. Where did it go? Who would do something like this?
It's awful.
It's just not fair.
It had to be Logger Vic.
Huh?
Look over here. Who else has one of these?
This is his chainsaw, all right. And I bet I know where that cotton leads to.
Yeah,
straight to Vic's house.
I'll lead the way. Follow me.
Right.
Vicky, honey, I hope you're keeping warm out there.
Don't worry, Ma. Oh, yeah. I was out in the woods and found a whole bunch of cotton, and I'm gonna make you the coziest quilt. Hey! It's because I love you.
I knew it was him. That's our cotton. You think he can just take it?
Yeah, not cool.
Crook, I was looking forward to sleeping on a soft cloud of cotton.
Bramble will get our cotton back no matter what. Move.
Right.
Oh, well, when I get paid on time, that is. Alrighty. Bye-bye now.
Logger Vic?
Briar, I haven't touched any trees today.
That may be true, but you did steal our cotton.
That's right, it's ours.
Say what? You mean this is yours?
Darn straight. What you're holding is cotton that we worked hard for all summer.
How do I know you're not just trying to steal it from me? Anyway, finders keepers, and I'm the lucky finder.
Huh? Come back!
You'll never take it from me!
Don't you shut that door!
Briar!
I'm the keeper, you're the weeper.
Logger Vic!
Open this door! Give us our cotton back!
Give it back, you mean!
Logger Vic!
Look at that, right where I left it. I'll start on Mom's quilt right away.
Open the door!
What's up?
How did you...
Briar Bramble, the cone!
Get away! No touching! I found it first!
We planted it months ago. It's ours.
You just came in and stole it after we did all the hard work.
Admit it,
Logger
Vic!
I did not.
Guys, help me grab this cotton!
You can't have any, bird brain!
Over here!
Give it back!
Briar!
Why, you? Stop taking my stuff!
Huh?
Hey, give it back! That is mine! Bramble, you put that back right now! Briar, you cut it out!
Stay back!
Bramble! Briar! I am going to clobber you!
Whoa, what is happening?
How did he do that thing with the cotton? It's so scary.
Yeah, the cotton. He broke it into pieces.
I don't have a clue. But he's very strong. Be careful.
You scared now? Be well aware of my bow of almighty power. So, yeah, if you want to get it, you're gonna have to come through me. How did you... That's it! My bow of power. It's broken. Darn. I don't think I can fix it.
Hurry, let's go.
My bow's broke, and the bears took all the cotton. How am I supposed to make the quilt I promised my mom?
Vicky, honey, I hope you're keeping warm out there.
Don't worry, Ma. Oh, yeah. I was out in the woods and found a whole bunch of cotton, and I'm gonna make you the coziest quilt. Hey! It's because I love you.
Did you hear that, bro? He was gonna make a cozy quilt for his mommy. Aw. Logger Vic, we're really sorry for breaking your bow.
We'd like to give you half the cotton to make up for it.
Come on, Vic. Cheer up, buddy.
You're the best.
All right, we better get this cotton home.
Cotton.
Let's go!
Briar, what if I made a quilt too? We could sleep on it and be warm all winter!
Wow, a quilt! That sounds nice! Ugh, I can feel it right now!
Sorry, I don't know how to make quilts.
I can help ya. I know how to make quilts. It'll be fun working together. So, come on!
Awesome sauce!
Only, the bow is broken.
Don't worry about that. We'll fix it for you.
Yeah! Hey, this baby's as good as new. Mwah. Get ready. We're going on a road trip to Quilt City.
Quilt City!
Those look nice. Good job, everybody.
Wow. They look so soft and cozy.
Wow. Perfect.
So cozy.
Great job, you guys.
Thank you.
Mama, I made this just for you.
Thanks, Vic. Thank you.
No, thank you. We did this together.
A real artist.
Good afternoon. You're watching the Daily News. In today's headlines, cabbages. A painting by renowned artist Charles Brown has just fetched $1 million on the auction.
Charlie? I went to school with that guy. He's famous now? Back at school, I was a way better painter than he ever was.
Can you believe it? A total of $1 million.
What the? $1 million? I bust my hump for pocket change. And all he does is paint a picture. Why is life so unfair to Logger Vicky? I got better grades than he did. Okay, I am determined. I'm picking up my brush again. How hard could it be to draw a cabbage? Perfect. Although it's been years, I'd say I still have it. I think I'll be famous overnight. I'll send this to the best magazines.
Oh no, Briar's catching up. I better hide somewhere quick.
Bramble?
La la la.
Logger Vic, so sorry.
Get back here.
Oh, my art.
Running, Bramble. Hey, eat everything that we've stored for the winter, Bramble.
Just look what you've done. Out of my way!
What?
You've ruined my painting!
What? When did you become a painter?
None of your business.
Sorry about that.
Today's weather forecast. Sunny throughout most of the day, with temperatures ranging from 26 to 32°C.
Hello, Mr. Logger Vic. This is the editor of Artist Weekly. We've just received some of your work.
Oh, really?
Your work seems like an abstract painting at first sight. But actually, it's kind of a total mess.
What?
As for that bear paw...
That was just...
The paw is simply creative genius. It's filled with the strength of the wild.
For sure. It's what I'm known for.
We'd like to plan an art exhibition for you. Perhaps if you've got any more of those bear paw paintings.
That'll be no problem. Exhibition?
You can get started on a new painting right away, and we'll contact you in a few days.
Good.
Have a great day. Goodbye.
It's happening. Hooray! I'm finally succeeding in life! Hang on, that was Bramble by mistake. Where am I gonna find a paw like that? What am I gonna do? Oh, that's perfect.
Invite me to create paintings?
Oh, sure. Do you remember ruining my painting with your paw? Well, I discovered a new artist. Okay.
An artist? You mean I'm an artist?
Of course. You're a genius. But even geniuses can suffer from a honey crisis.
Whoa! Yeah, I'll do it!
These are great.
I'm Super Bear.
Let's get back to it.
It's Bramble's time to shine. Hey, Logger Vic, how about you join me?
No, I couldn't
do
that.
Come on, let's do it.
Hey, stop peeking. It's not even finished
don't
yet.
Don't be shy.
Bramble, you give that back to me.
When I get home, I'll hang it on the wall.
Bramble, where have you been all day?
Oh, I'm sorry, bro. I've been busy painting this last few days, though I haven't had time to look for honey.
You've been painting? Well, don't be shy. Let's have a look.
No problem. Oh, I almost forgot. Logger Vic said he wanted to collect my paintings, so he kept all of them.
What? He wants to keep the paintings you made? What's he up to? Come on, we'll go get your paintings back.
Huh? Hey!
Ah, This ought to earn me the respect I deserve.
So why do I only have to draw bear paws?
It's what sets you apart.
But we draw pictures for fun, not for fame.
Forget it. Eyes on the prize.
Logger Vic?
Oh, who could that be?
Logger Vic?
Couldn't this wait till tomorrow?
What are they doing here? Go away. Got to hide these.
Open up, Logger Vic.
Fire.
Open
Maybe
up.
Vic's not being bad.
Huh?
Hey, a bear. What are you doing here, huh?
I heard you had some of Bramble's art.
I'd like to see them.
Oh, yeah.
Are you going to give them back?
Now? Oh, be cool. Chill out. Oh, come in for some fruit.
Fruit? I'd love some fruit, yeah!
Bramble, come back here.
Must be in the fridge.
No way! My fridge is broken, that's all. All the fruit's over here. I've got loads of apples. For you, Briar.
No!
Don't open that! No!
What? Bramble!
Huh? What's the matter?
Look, bro, did you paint this?
Yeah, I made this yesterday. Hey, Logger Vic, why'd you put these in the fridge? That's silly.
It's a new kind of cold storage technology. It protects the painting's integrity better.
And what about this? Is this for preservation?
That's nothing. It's just a small trademark, so people recognize us.
Enough! Do you think I'm stupid? You just want to make money off of Bramble's art.
Logger Vic, is it true? You were just lying to me all along?
Don't you know what intellectual property is? This is too far. These are Bramble's paintings, and it's time he got them back.
What? Hold on. You can't take them away. They're mine, too. I'll give them back after the exhibition.
These belong to Bramble.
Please, I'll buy you all kinds of candies.
My paintings!
My heart.
My back.
Yeah.
Hi, Vic. How are those preparations coming along?
Bramble, I'm so sorry, buddy.
They're ruined.
What? Ruined? Are you kidding me? We put a lot of effort and investment into that exhibition. Now you're telling me it's all ruined? You are taking full responsibility for compensating our losses. Every last cent!
I don't really know that much about fame, but I just love painting. And I know you like it too. If you still want to draw pictures with me, just come to the usual place.
Bramble. This is the place that we did all our painting. Oh, yeah. These are really great. This is the hat that Bramble wore.
Logger Vic!
He must be so angry. It's my fault, really. I was greedy. I'm so sorry. I'm such a fool. I'd do anything to make it better.
Hey, Logger Vic!
Huh? What?
I've been waiting here all day! Close your eyes and come with me! Come on!
Where are you going?
Okay, now. Open your eyes. Look!
Pretty!
What's this?
Logger Vic, you like our art gallery? This was all Bramble's idea. Although, I guess it won't make you famous or anything.
Thanks, my friend. Isn't this my painting? What's it doing here? Oh, this is so embarrassing.
Let me have a look. Oh, I like it. Artistic.
Yeah, it's got kind of a postmodern vibe. might look better if you add a banana.
In my kingly opinion, it is needed pineapple.
I prefer a nice jar of honey.
You see, Vic? You're kind of a celebrity now at Pine Tree Mountain. We can draw together again anytime you want. Could I get your autograph?
Rock.
Wow.
A true artist!
Mr. Tomato Head. Oh, Vic here.
Victor, are you sleeping?
I am, certainly. Why wouldn't I?
Because you're supposed to be working! You haven't cut down one tree for me this month! No trees, no money! No money, no food!
Hey, hold on, you. I haven't got a salary in months, eh? So don't try and threaten me! You know, I'm starving in my own home! Ah, don't push me! Why should I work for you? You don't pay me! Ah, hungry.
Hey, easy there, Vic. I've had some cash flow problems recently. I haven't got two dimes to rub together.
Big deal.
All right. I'll send you some food so you can fill your stomach and get back to work.
I don't want any junk food, you hear? No instant noodles or stuff that isn't healthy for me. I only want fresh food, okay?
Okay. It'll be 100% natural.
Food.
Enjoy.
Well, let's see what we got here. Look at the size of that tomato. Okay, dig in. That's delicious. I'm in heaven. Tomatoes. Beautiful tomatoes. What the? Can't be. It's raining tomatoes. Yay. Hold on, I'm coming. What? Super big tomato. This is the best tomato ever. Oh, my butt, that hurts. Why do I have a tail? What's going on with my feet? What the? You're kidding me. I'm a tomato. Oh, no. No. This can't be happening. I'm not a tomato! My feet? My butt? My head? Oh, it was just a dream. Still alive. I've had so many tomatoes lately. It's turning into a nightmare.
Yo, Logan Vic, you got a package, mate.
How can it be tomatoes again? I can't even stand the sight of them anymore. How you doing?
Hello, Vic. How you liking them tomatoes? Are they fresh enough for you? I got plenty more of them.
I was wondering, have you got any other, vegetables, besides tomatoes?
What? Those tomatoes were grown on a vegetable farm in my hometown! They're certified organic and natural as can be! Now stop being so picky and get out there and cut me some trees!
I don't believe those tomatoes are certified organic! I bet you picked them up from the dump! Jeez. Have to not eat more tomatoes, or I'll become a monster! I've made my decision, no more! But I don't have money to buy anything else. That's it. All right. I'll just plant my own food. What a genius idea that is!
I'm starving.
I'm eating food.
Good morning, Saya.
Babu, what did you find?
I found a ton of tomatoes.
Oh, it's the world of tomatoes. Tomatoes are tasty. Why he be throwing them out? Lagervik, it is a shame to be throwing away food like this. Lagervik, can you hear me?
We can't just come in when Lagervik's not home, Saya.
Mm-hmm. We are civilized and well-bred. We will be waiting.
This just in from the Food Administration. Large batches of rotten tomatoes have somehow made their way onto the market. If you accidentally eat a bad tomato, watch out! Please choose your tomatoes carefully. That's today's news. A great day.
The tomatoes got him! Briar! Bravo! Somebody help! It's an emergency! Oh, it's not good!
I feel terrible.
What happened to you?
Briar, I ate some detrimental tomatoes that Lagervik abandoned.
Saya, save your strength!
Vic again?
La 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 la. Oh yeah. Time for a break. They don't look as good as the ones from Boss. But at least they're natural and organic. Okay, back to it. What the?
Lagervik? Do you know what you've done? You've thrown toxic tomatoes everywhere, and now Tiki here is sick.
Toxic? Whoa.
Tiki, hang in there, buddy.
All my friends can't go on. I love you all.
Tiki? Tiki!
Briar, I'm saving some ripe bananas and,
Saya, don't leave me alone in this world!
Will he be all right?
This is all your fault!
Say what?
Admit it! He ate the tomatoes you threw in the yard!
Why, guys? Why do you always make me out to be the bad guy, huh? Because I'm not always that guy. You know what? They were from my boss.
From your boss? Did you eat any of them?
Yes. But I didn't get sick, and I didn't throw them away either. Whoa, hey. I just had them in the front yard.
Babu?
Yes. Well, we didn't find them in the trash. We found them in Lockervik's yard.
Babu! I can't believe you two stole his food. That's kind of a crime, you know. We'll talk later. But first, we gotta save Tiki.
Lagervik, can you do something?
Will you just put me down?
Oh, whoops.
Oh, ow!
Yeah, sorry about that, Vicky. It was just a misunderstanding.
They steal and eat my food, and you come after me. You guys have gone too far this time. Goodbye.
Please save my sire. Save my sire. I'm begging you, Vic.
What are we gonna do now?
Poor Tiki, I need you to calm down.
Where's Super Bear?
Alrighty, I'll help you and give him a quick check. Temperature seems normal. Strong heartbeat there.
Oh, Tiki.
Let me see.
That man. How is he? Can you wake him up?
I'm not sure. Stomach's hard. Hey, Babu, can you tell me how many tomatoes he ate?
Huh? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10, 15. Oh, wait, like 30 tomatoes?
He ate 30 tomatoes at one sitting? Well, that explains it. Indigestion. He's a piggy. It's nothing serious.
Really?
Briar, Tiki's the tomatoes. I'll be back from the dead.
Tiki, if it's no big deal, why did you go into a coma?
Well, the truth is that tomatoes making me very tiredly. So I took a nap, okay?
Sire, I was so sad that I thought you were gonna
It's okay. I'll never be ditching you.
That's so moving.
Hey, Lagervik, if you know your boss's tomatoes are safe to eat, then why are you planting new vegetables?
He hasn't paid my salary in a few months, so he paid me in tomatoes. And, I totally got sick of eating them all the time. Huh? Tomato after tomato. Every day tomatoes. For a while there, I even thought I was turning into a tomato. I needed some variety. So I planted my garden. Oh, the cabbages were doing well. And the eggplants. And the zucchini. I was gonna make salad. It was the only thing I could do to supplement my vegetables. You should try some.
Don't mind if I do. It is good.
I wasn't kidding you. I put a lot of effort into that garden for sure. Oh.
Oh, tasty. So much better. I need some more.
You didn't ask my permission.